physical fitness test. A subtle measure designed to determine a student's level of physical fitness. What are the objectives of this test? To determine the level of fitness of students. To identify strengths and weaknesses for development and improvement. To provide baseline data for selection of physical activities for enhancement of health and school performance. To gather data for development of norms and standards. To motivate, guide, and counsel pupils or students in selecting sports or recreation, competition, and lifetime participation. CIPR test. Purpose. To test the flexibility of the shoulder girdle. Equipment, ruler. Procedure. Stand erect. Raise your arm, bend your elbow, and reach down across your back as far as possible. Extend your left arm down and beyond your back. Bend your elbow up across your back and try to reach or cross your fingers over those of your right hand as if to pull the zipper or scratch between the shoulder blades. For the partner, observe whether the finger touch or overlap each other. If not, measure the gap between the middle finger of both hands. Record the distance in centimeters. Scoring. Record zipper test to the nearest 0.1 cm. 0. Did not touch fingertips. 1. Just touch fingertips. 2. Fingers overlap by 1 or 2 cm. 3. Fingers overlap by 3 to 4 cm. 4. Fingers overlap by 5 to 7 cm. 5. Fingers overlap by 8 cm and more. Sit and reach. Purpose. To test the flexibility of the lower back and extremities. Equipment, tape measure or meter stick, cardboard or paper. Procedure. For the performer. Sit on the floor with back, head and shoulders flat on the wall. Feet are 12 inches apart. Interlock thumbs and position the tip of the fingers on the floor without bending the elbows. Reach up. Place hands on the top of the cardboard or paper where the tips of the middle fingers are at the top of the edge of the cardboard or paper. Start the test by pushing the cardboard or paper slowly and try to reach the farthest distance possible without bending the knees. Hold for 2 seconds. No bending and jerking of knees and no too much opening of legs. Scoring. Record the distance to the nearest 0.1 cm. Push up. Purpose. To measure strength of upper extremities. Equipment. Exercise mat or any clean mat. Procedure. For the performer. Lie down on the mat. Face down in standard push-up position. Palms on the mat about shoulder width. Fingers pointing forward and legs straight, parallel and slightly apart, with the toes supporting the feet. For boys, straighten arms, keeping the back and knees straight, then lower the arm until there is a 90-degree angle at the elbows. Upper arms are parallel to the floor. For girls, with knees in contact with the floor, straighten the arms, keeping the back straight, then lower the arm until there is a 90-degree angle at the elbow or upper arm are parallel to the floor. Perform as many repetitions as possible, maintaining a cadence of 20 push-ups per minute, 2 seconds going down to 1 second going up. For the partner, as the performer assumes the position of push-up, start counting as the performer lowers his or her body until he or she reaches 90-degree angle at the elbow. Make sure that the performer executes the push-ups in the correct form. Test is terminated when the performer can no longer execute the push-up in the correct form if any pain, voluntary step, or cadence is broken. Basic plank. Purpose. To measure strength and stability of the core muscles. Equipment. Exercise mat or any clean mat. Procedure. For the performer. Assume a push-up position. Rest bottom, forearms with the palms and fingers flat on the floor. Elbows are aligned with the shoulder. Legs are straight with ankles, knees, and thighs touching together. Support weight on forearms and toes. Make sure that your back is flat. Head, neck, and spine are in a straight line. Keep abdominals engaged or contracted. Do not let stomach drop or allow hips to rise. For the partner, ensure the availability of a mat or smooth floor or anything that can protect the forearm. Give the signal start, go, and start press the timepiece. Make sure that the back of the head, neck, spine, and ankles are in straight line. Stop the time when the performer can no longer hold the required position. Or when the performer has held a position for at least 90 seconds, holding the prone position beyond 90 seconds is considered unnecessary. Scoring. Record the time in the nearest second or minute. Standing long jump. Purpose. To measure the explosive strength and power of the leg muscle. Equipment, tape measure, or meter stick. Procedure for the performer. Stand behind the takeoff line with the toes parallel to each other. The tips of the shoes should not go beyond the line. Bend the knees and swing arms backward once. Then swing arms forward and switch up and on both knees. Try the jump as far as you can. To control the momentum of the jump, continuously move forward. Perform press twice in succession. For the partner, place your point to the tape measure at the takeoff line. After the jump, spot the mark where the back of the heel of either feet of the performer has landed nearest to the takeoff line. Record the best distance in meters to the near 0.1 cm. Scoring. Record the best distance in meters to the near 0.1 cm. Stick trap test. Purpose. To measure the time to respond to a stimulus. Equipment. 24-inch ruler or stick, armchair or table and chair. Procedure for the performer. Sit on an armchair or chair next to the table so that the elbow and lower arm rest on the desk or table comfortably. Place the heel of the hand on the desk or table so that only the fingers and thumb extend beyond. Touch the ruler or stick to the thumb and index finger without lifting the elbow from the desk or table as the partner drops the stick. Hold the stick while the partner reads the measurement. Do this twice. For the partner, hold the ruler or stick at the top, allowing it to dangle between thumb and finger of the performer. Hold the ruler or stick so that the 24-inch mark index finger. No part of the hand of the performer should touch the ruler or stick. Tap the ruler or stick without warning and let the performer catch it with his or her thumb and index finger. Scoring. Record the middle of the three scores, for example. If the scores are 21, 18, and 19, and the middle score is 19. Start balance stance first. Purpose. To assess one's ability to maintain equilibrium. Equipment. Flat and stiff surface. Stopwatch. Procedure for the performer. Remove the shoes and place hands on hips. Position the right foot against the inside knee of the left foot. Raise the left heel to balance on the ball of the foot. Do the same procedure with the opposite
foot. Game.
For the partner, start the time as the heel of the performer is raised off the floor. Stop the time if any of the following occurs. The hands come up the hips. The supporting foot swivels or moves, hops in any direction. The non-supporting foot loses contact with the knee. The heel of the supporting foot touches the floor. Scoring. Record the time taken on both feet in the nearest seconds. Thank you for watching.